Have you ever wondered how to clean up your text so it actually looks right on your slide? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to use the paragraph section in PowerPoint so you can achieve that. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so on this slide, I just have a background image with a cabin in the winter and then some blank text fields. And you're going to see here a section called paragraph. So I'm going to type in some text right here before we can actually play around with that section. And I'm just going to type in my YouTube channel name. And then I'll also type in some filler text right here. And so now what I want to do is, you'll see that if you don't have anything selected, it's grayed out. But in order to actually get those functionalities to appear, you have to have some type of text box selected. All right, so now that I have this text box selected, I can pick through all these different functionalities here. So if I want to add a bullet point, I can click here and I'll add a bullet point. I can also choose the type of bullet point I want to use. And then if I want to change the color of my bullet points, I can click on this drop down arrow here with this paint bucket and then pick a color that I would like. So I can pick this orange color, hit OK. And then again, if you want any type of different styling, feel free to explore the different ones, and it's going to show a preview before selecting it, which is really nice. Another thing too is that you can choose it to be numbered here as well. And then you could say start with 2, start with 3. So you don't have to start with the actual number 1 if you don't want to, but that's just a way to toggle through it right here. And then you can also choose the size percentage of the text, so you can make it really small. And then if you hit OK, it's going to make it a little bit smaller. Another thing is that you get the same functionality right here as well. So if you ever want to toggle on and off the numbers, you can do it right here. And the same thing happens where you can hover over these options and see what's available to you. Another thing too is, let's say I don't have the numbers selected or the bullets selected, and I just have plain text. What you can do is you can actually choose how you want to align your text. So if you want align to the left, you can do that. You can also do Control L to align it to the left. So let's say I did Control L. That's another way of aligning it to the left. Same thing with middle. If you want in the middle, you can do Control E. And then if you want to align it to the right, you could do Control R. So that's just a quick way to align your text in PowerPoint without having to go all the way up to this paragraph section to click on one of these options. That is always there for you just in case you don't remember the shortcuts though. All right, so the next thing I want to show you guys is how to use justify. So let's say you want your text to flush all the way to the left and all the way to the right evenly. This is how you can do it. If you hit justify right here, it's now going to push out that text evenly so it's flush on both sides. All right, so the next feature I want to show you guys is this two column feature right here. So if I highlight all this text and then do two columns, it's now going to make those two bullet points in two columns. Now, if you did this without bullet points, it may look a little funky and kind of squished. You can always go into view and then ruler and then move the second column over more just so it has some more space, and make sure you have both the top and the bottom of those selected so you can scoot it over. I'm going to be honest with you though, using the two column feature can get a little wonky. So what I would recommend is actually making two separate text boxes and then putting them side by side. And that way you can really manipulate what you want in the first column and the right. All right. So another thing I want to show you guys is how to actually indent text. So you can actually do a tab, and that's another way of indenting, but they also have this indent feature right here. So you can tab in this way and tab out that way as well. Let's say you have some more information right here and you want to indent it to the right, you can hit tab. Or what you can do is you can also hit this indent right here. And then if you ever want to go back, you can just hit the back arrow to undo the indents kind of, or you can also do undo. But this is just a way to indent to the right or indent to the left. All right, so the next feature I want to show you guys is line spacing. So what's really cool about this is that if you just select a text box and then go up here to line spacing, you can choose how much space you actually want between your text. So maybe you want it really crammed in, or maybe you want it really spaced out. This is a way to manipulate it. So if you don't see the amount of spacing that you actually want, you can choose this line spacing options right here, and then you can choose multiple, and then you can customize how much spacing you actually want in between your lines if you don't see it in that dropdown. And that will really manipulate how much spacing you can get. There's also other options in here as well for other features, so feel free to explore those as well. All right, so the next thing I want to show you guys is text direction. So what's really cool about this is, let's say I go into shapes and I got this shape, just typing in text right here. And then I want this text to now be going along this line right here. What's cool about text direction is that you can make that happen. So all you have to do is rotate it, and then now it's going to be flushing that way instead of being horizontal like this. So that's just a fun way to change how the text is rotated, and let's say maybe you got like a graph going on and this is supposed to be like the side key for the bar and you got like a graph going right here and you just want to have some text, that would be a great use case to use text direction. All right, so another thing I want to show you guys is with align text. So as you can see here, I have this text box. My text is all flushed towards the bottom of this text box. Now, if I want it in the center of the text box, what I can do here is go to align text and then say middle. And now it's going to sit within the middle of that text box. So no matter how much I adjust this, it's always going to stay in the center of that text box, which is really nice. You can do the same for top and you can do the same for bottom. The last thing I want to show you guys is convert to SmartArt. So I don't really use this feature that much, to be honest, but it's there for you and it's a nice tool just in case you do want to make quick graphics. So if you click on this drop down arrow, it's going to give you a bunch of different infographics that you can plug and play with that PowerPoint did provide you with. Again, I don't use this feature too much just because I like to personally customize my own infographics, but this is a feature just in case you want to see what kind of smart graphics you can include with the text that you typed in. And you can always click on more smart art graphics and it's going to show you a bunch of different use cases for whatever you're trying to do. All right, so the last thing I want to show you guys is this expand icon right here. So if I click on this, it's going to then show up again the same thing that you saw when I clicked on this right here. There's two places to get this feature, and if you just click this expand icon, they're both going to show you the same type of information. That is everything that you can do in the paragraph section. If you guys did find this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I do have a course on Udemy. I'll have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.